What's up, guys? My name is Victor, and today I'm going to talk about what I believe to be the best diet for people who are going through the spiritual awakening or ascension process, light workers, etc. Now, I know you're probably suspecting I'm going to talk about high vibrational foods and eating more of like a vegetarian or even a vegan diet or a raw food diet. This is the advice that is very commonly put out there in regards to the being a highly enlightened and higher vibrational being on this planet. And not to say it's untrue, but in my opinion, that's it's not the only way, and it's because the process is so dynamic, there are different times that require different nutritional practices. There are certainly times where it is best to eat very lighter foods, high vibration foods, which include, of course, living foods, fruits, vegetables, nuts and seeds that are still raw and have not yet been processed. Those are high vibrational foods. They're very nutritious. They're very full of micronutrients and will keep you very healthy. But we're still on the planet Earth, and we're not like a year away from just kind of ascending into the cosmos. We're going to be here a while, okay? We're physical beings. And not only that, the ascension process in and of itself is an incredible stress to our physical body. It's almost like we're working out every day just by like processing these high vibrational energies. So many times it requires a lot of protein, a lot of meat, okay? And sometimes you'll find that you might even crave like junk foods. Sometimes we need like these unhealthy foods to kind of ground ourselves, because if we try to speed up the process with a special diet, then we can end up inviting in more energy, more higher dimensional energies than our body is ready for. And that can just cause more imbalance, more imbalance, basically. And that the more imbalanced you are unnecessarily, then the less of a role you can really be, the less of a service you can be by being your light worker self. If you're all messed up and like jarred, then what good are you? And I say this because I've made all these mistakes. I used to be a 100% raw vegan, and it had its place. It was excellent. I felt really good for a while, but then there came a time where that particular diet was not working for me. I started getting sick all the time. I lost way too much weight. I'm like 175 pounds now. Imagine me at almost 30 pounds lighter. People were worried about me. My skin started to kind of look poor, and I just felt really weak. But I was so like convinced that, oh, I'm a light worker, I gotta eat this way, that I clung to it in denial of and not acknowledging what was actually going on with my physical body. So once I came to terms with that, I kind of gave in to my body's urges, I felt a lot better. But my point is that I have fluctuated significantly throughout my entire, over the past 8 years, I've been going through this journey, and my diet is always changing because it's such a dynamic thing we're all going through. So I recommend you just be fluid and open and listen to your body. Listen to your body's consciousness. It will tell you pretty clearly what it wants, basically by what it craves. Whatever you happen to be like into at the time is usually what you need. Now, with that said, there does need to be a certain level of purity to your diet, because if you start eating McDonald's every day, then all you're gonna, of course, you're gonna create the craving for McDonald's. But that's not your body telling you it needs McDonald's, okay? So with any diet, there should be at least a decent percentage, around 50 or 60% of very healthy foods, okay? So I just wanted to go over that, guys, because I see a lot of bullshit out there. A lot of people who function very well with a vegan diet all of a sudden think it's their position, their role to start telling everyone how they should eat, that everyone needs to do this, and that's not true, okay? I started to feel miserable on a vegan diet, and it's not because I wasn't doing it correctly. I've been a personal trainer for over 10 years. I'm incredibly well-versed on nutrition. In fact, I would even argue that I was eating a better nutritionally sound vegan diet than most of the vegans out there, okay? It wasn't working for me. But some people function beautifully on a pure vegan diet for their whole life. You just have to be honest with yourself. How is this making me feel? Okay? So I will briefly end with just a few different tips. So there's a few different, even though the process is very dynamic, there are somewhat discernible stages. some of the stages are when you feel guided towards like lightening your load, clearing your energy, trying to really get into like your meditative and intuitive side, where you're really trying to house a lot of your psychic energy. That's when you want to eat the high vibrational foods. That's when you might want to veer towards like a vegetarian diet for a while. At the same time, after a period of that for a little while, you're going to find yourself becoming burnt out by that, and you're going to need to kind of ground yourself and rebuild your muscles and rebuild your body. In that case, eat more of a higher protein diet, okay? And when the grounding is really essential, allow yourself to eat junk foods. It's okay. It's in balance to eat super healthy all the time, okay? But above all else, listen to your body, all right? Hope you guys enjoy that video. I will see you next time.